Use the following probabilities to answer the question. It may be helpful to sketch a Venn diagram, which we will do. We're given the probability of A equals 0.35, the probability of B equals 0.4, and the probability of A and B equals 0.25. We want to find the probability of B given not A, which is conditional probability defined here below. So the probability of B given not A equals the probability of not A and B divided by the probability of not A. Now to help us do this, let's complete the Venn diagram. We'll begin with the intersection of A and B. Notice the probability of A and B equals 0.25. So the probability of being in this region here is 0.25. Now the probability of A equals 0.35, but this does include this probability because this is an A, and therefore the probability of being in this region, which is only A, would be 0.35 minus 0.25, or 0.1. And then because the probability of B equals 0.4, which again includes this probability, the probability of only B would be 0.4 minus 0.25, or 0.15. We also want to find the probability of not A and not B, or the probability of being in this outer region. Well, the probability of only being in the outer region would be 1 minus the sum of these probabilities, which would be 0.5. Again, we can find this by taking 1, which is the probability of being in the universal set, and then subtracting the sum of these three probabilities. So 0.1 plus 0.25 plus 0.15 again gives us the probability of being in the universal set but not in A and not in B. Now before we find these two probabilities, let's highlight the region that would be not A and B, as well as the region that's not A. The region that's not in A and in B would have to be the region here that's only in B. Again, this is the region that is not in A and also in B. And then the region that's not A would be all the region that's outside set A, which should be this entire region here. So the probability of not A and B is the probability of being only in B, which is 0.15, divided by the probability of not A. To find that probability, we would find the sum of these two probabilities, or 1 minus the sum of these two probabilities. Notice 0.5 plus 0.15 is 0.65. So notice how to find the probability of B given not A, we found the probability of the desired region, which is only B, and then divided by the probability of the total region given not A, which is the probability 0.65. And now let's write this probability as a simplified fraction as well as a decimal and percentage. To clear the decimals, we can multiply by 100 over 100, which gives us 15/65ths, but now we have a common factor of 5. So dividing the numerator and denominator by 5, our simplified probability as a fraction is 3/13ths. Let's also convert to a decimal and percentage. To convert to a decimal, we divide 3 divided by 13 to 4 decimal places would be approximately 0.2308. To convert to a percentage, we multiply by 100, add a percent sign, or move the decimal point to the right two places and add a percent sign, giving us 23.08%. Notice how the only exact probability is the one in fraction form. So for our homework, we should enter the fractional probability, even though we often do see probability as a decimal and percentage. But here, notice how they are approximations because we did round. I hope you found this helpful.